everybody, and welcome back to another Minecraft video. This is Mythical Sausage. How is everybody doing? Oh man, we're back again doing another tutorial, and today we're doing a Minecraft 1.15 modern survival starter house. Now the materials on this is very simple to get. Just stone, cobble, some spruce, a little bit of dark oak, and you can make this in your world really super simple and super quick and super easy. It's not that big, and we can do it together, interior and all. Let's do this block for block. And here we go with the block palette. We're going to be using some strip spruce log, some spruce planks, some dark oak fences, the fence gate. We're using some stone, stone slab, cobble, and any glass color of your choice. And here we go with the dimensions. So everything is all laid out in wool. You can count out the blocks and see exactly how much space you're going to be needing. If you notice the red and the light blue, that's just going to be the outline for the roads around and the walled off area that's going to go around the house. The house itself is only the magenta and the white sections, and also the orange and yellow sections. So that's just the house you're going to be needing. The rest is extra. All right, now we're going to be starting with the stripped spruce wood, and we're going to be putting these on all the pink and white sections, this side, this section, and that section over here. So let's start right here, and let's start counting these blocks. So let's start right at this edge of this corner. Let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and we're going to put it this and just double it up on both sides. And then we're going to recess this section in down by one. It's going to have a nice water feature. So let's take these logs all the way down, at least one more level so you can see it through that water. Now that we have this in place, let's lift all of this up by 11, starting on this block. So this is already one. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Now let's raise this whole section up by 11. All right, now that this is up by 11, we're going to grab our dark oak planks and go from here. 1, 2, 3 on this section. We're going to go up by 4. Going to give it a space here of 1, 2, 3 on the third one. We're going to put a dark oak stair upside down. Take this down. We're going to go up again by 4 and then up again by 4. Take the little bit out and we have our front door entrance. So right here, we're going to take this down right here so it goes at least down to that water level. And then from here, this is already a 1. So let's go 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 and take this all up right here by 4. Now in this back section, we're going to go right from the top level on this 4, and we're going to take it all the way down here, replace these 3, and then we're going to add some glass from top to bottom. Now let's grab our strip spruce, and we're going to go ahead and lift up from here. So if you notice, it's 2 from this side, 2 from this side, and we're going to lift these 3. So right here, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3. Now let's take this one up exactly like we had over there, up by 11. And there it is. This wood is matching the 11 from this wood. Now let's grab our stone and we're going to go right from this corner. Let's go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and another 1 and 2. And it kind of wraps around just like so. And then if you count from the bottom, this is a 1, 2, 3, 4. It's on level 5 right here. Now let's take this up another, this is already a 1. So 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And then let's fill in this section right here. And it should be one block before the top over here. Then we're going to go ahead and connect right from this line. And then we have this space right here for a window. And then fill it in with glass just like that. Now for this, we're going to go ahead and continue this line and just pretty much match exactly what we did there. So right on the top level, take it up and around. Cover up this section until we get to the one right before the top right there. Take this all the way back and we have a quick mirror job. And let's fill this with glass as well. There we go. So that's filled in with glass. Now, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to have this piece of stone pop out from the back side over here. So right here, we're just going to follow this line and take it right to there. So right one before the end and just take it all the way down and just stop right at this line. So matching what we did over here. And then we're going to do the same thing on this line. So right there, matching perfectly. And then let's take this all the way down just like so. And that is looking pretty cool. Now we're going to detail this line over here, this section between the stones. For this one, I'm just going to make it simple. Let's go ahead and just put a bunch of fence gates here of our dark oak. And then we're going to pepper in also a little bit of our fences as well. So come in here and just randomly scatter this just to make it look cool. A little bit of an art piece there. And it looks really nice. Something like that looks pretty cool. There it is. It broke up that whole wall and it looks really awesome. We can add a bunch more. You can even, if you want to, we can add some bush. I'm going to go with some just regular old oak leaf and just maybe break in a few. And we can go ahead and just scatter this around just like that, just to give it a little bit of detail. And you don't have to do this, but it just adds a little bit more right there. Just a little bit of scattering of our bushes right here. Maybe one more up top right there. That's cool. Now the next thing, let's go ahead and just cover up this section over here just with our stone. just like that. And then we're gonna go on the inside really quickly and then cover up this section in stone as well. And now once we have that, I wanna give a little bit of texture to this build. You don't have to do this part, you can leave it clean just like this, but I think adding just a little bit of texture will make it look pretty cool. So I'm just gonna come in here and just randomly scatter on the stone a little bit of cobble, just like so, just to give it a little bit of extra detail coming around, just like that. Maybe another little splatter there, another little bit right there. You don't have to add too much, just a little bit like that goes a long way. Maybe another one and two right there. It's perfect. Now, also on the wood section on this strip, I'm gonna go ahead and add some of our spruce planks as well. Just random locations right here. This also breaks up this flat wall a little bit by doing that. It just goes around just a little bit and just add a little bit of that texture there. Now, next bit, we're gonna go right in front of this log section and just put three more logs here. We're gonna go one, two, and three. And then take this up, another one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So seven from the main line right here, not from the bottom. So seven right there. From here, we're gonna go ahead and grab some of our gates, and we have it on us already. I'm gonna go down from here. One, two, three. One, two, three, and one, two, and three, just like so. And then over here, we're gonna go ahead and overhang a little bit of bush. So I'm gonna go with our oak bush. You can go with really any bush you like, but I'm gonna go ahead and drape this around and down right on this side. It just adds a little bit of detail here to the water feature that's gonna be underneath. So something like that, we can break some off, take some out, and just come around like so, and that makes it look pretty cool right there. There it is, that looks pretty nice. Now, I'm also gonna add a little bit of that texture over here by bringing in some of those planks, just like that. Now, next up, let's grab some buttons. I'm gonna put some stone buttons on the top here. One, two, and three. Three up here. We're gonna put two on this side, and then two over here on this side, just to add a little bit more. Now, the next thing we're gonna do, I'm gonna grab a cobble wall. I'm gonna put one right here on the corner bit, and then hang a lantern just from there. All right, now we're almost done. So right here, let's go ahead and run some details here. I'm gonna put a slab lining of stone all the way around here. So starting from this corner, it is gonna be one, two, three. From here, another one, two, and three. And then just take this all the way down, and it's gonna connect right to the end of the house right there. And then replace the bottom part with stone. Now that we have that, we're gonna do the same thing over here on this side. So we're gonna go right from the edge, one, two, three, four, five. From here, another one, two, three, four, and five. Over on this one over here, we're gonna grab some spruce bush and take it down. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. And then let's come back to this side, another one, two, three, and four. Here we're gonna grab our stone slab again and go one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. And then replace the bottom part with stone. Now last bit, we're gonna go right from here, say space of three, and we're gonna go line it up right from here. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. It stops right here on this line. And then just for the grounds, I just put gravel and a little bit of stone brick. For this recessed in section, everything is gonna be out of sand all the way around. And then let me show you how to decorate this water feature. All right, now for decoration, I'm gonna grab some mossy stairs. I'm gonna put them down on the ground, just like so. Then I'm gonna go ahead and add a slab to the middle, just like that. Let's do another little bit of slab action on certain parts here. It's gonna be random anywhere, really. I'm gonna add some more stairs and some more slabs. Maybe another one in this corner, maybe one here. Just randomly scatter these. You can even maybe put some in the ground as well, so that's perfectly okay. Also, we're gonna add a little bit of sea pickle action, just at random spots, just like so. And then let's fill this thing with water really quick. Now, once the water is in place, let's go ahead and add a little bit of seagrass in certain spots. Add some kelp as well, just randomize, and it doesn't have to be just completely all covered. I'll just scatter it just a little bit like so. And then other things you can add is maybe a lily pad every so often, maybe at certain spots, just strategically placed. There we go. And then also add some salmon. It was like a little bit of a koi pond now, and that's really awesome. Also did the same thing on this side, which is cool. I'm not gonna add any fish here. It's too small of a space, just over here. Now the last bit of detail here on the outside, just gonna add a little flower pot here to this corner, and then any flower would do. But that's it. Our build is completely done. But now let me show you the interior. Now, step number one for the interior, let's drop a door. I'm gonna put a simple old dark oak door. I'm gonna pop out a hole right there. We're gonna put a ladder to go up. So one, two, three, and four right there. And that'll be just an easy way to get to the second floor. Over here, we could recess in some stuff because we do have that extra block over there. So let's knock down this whole section right here, this little 4x3 right over here. I'm gonna go ahead and replace that wall right there. Now from here, we can add a small kitchen. Let's go with a furnace in the center. Let's go with a crafting table on one side. Let's go with a cauldron on the other. I'm gonna grab some of our stone brick stairs right here. Let's put an upside down stair right above right here. Let's also grab some stone brick slabs. I'm gonna put one on this corner, one on this corner. Let's drop some barrels on the top for storage right there. And on the bottom here, we can grab a lantern, light this place up a little bit. Right there, we could even add a little cake right here. Why not? It's a kitchen after all. Let's put a little cake right there. Perfect. Now on this side, we can recess in a little bit as well. Let's knock down these right here. I'm gonna go all the way to the top like we did over here. Let's go ahead and put our dark oak on that side. I'm gonna put a strip dark oak log in the center right here. And then let's grab some stairs. I'm gonna go with, let's do some spruce stairs here. You can go with any stair though. I'm gonna put one on each side, just like so. Then on the top here, maybe grab a flower pot and let's maybe throw a plant in there. Why not? Let's go ahead and drop that right there. Let's grab also some extra slabs. I'm gonna go with our spruce slabs and it's gonna give it a little bit of a lining up here. And then let's also grab a painting and let's drop a painting right in the center, right about there. That's pretty cool, perfect. Then over here, let's get an item frame and also I wanna drop a little clock right here. So let's drop this right in the center. Also, I wanna grab some buttons just to dress this up a little bit. I'm gonna go with the oak ones. Let's drop that here, buttons on the side, and let's drop our clock in the center. In the middle here, we could put a small little carpet. So I'm gonna just go with a small, simple white carpet and go right from here. Let's just put it right in the center, 1, 2, and 3. We have a nice little white carpet there. And then also, let's grab a composter. Let's also grab some bush. I'm gonna go with, let's go with a simple oak one. And then let's also go with a dead bush. And then we're gonna do this cool trick that I love to do. Let's put a composter, fill this up with bush until we get the compost all the way to the top, right there. Put a flower pot, a dead bush, and let's grab and put a little small bush on top. We have this nice area right here. Now let's go to the second floor. Now on the second floor, let's drop a dark oak trapdoor here for safety reasons. I'm gonna give this a little bit of detail. Let's put an upside down spruce stair here. Let's put a placeholder block. Let's put one right here. And this gives us a little bit of a room divider. Let's grab a slab of our spruce. Let's put that in the center right there. And then let's put 3 flower pots. And then just gonna put bamboo on each. It's like one of the taller ones. This or cactus actually looks pretty cool as a room divider. So we have this ready to go. All right, now for this side, let's make a little bedroom here. So I'm gonna knock down these up here all the way to the top. I'm gonna drop 2 slabs on that as well. Let's put a light maybe on one of those with a lantern. And over here, maybe some, we could do some sea pickles. Looks like a little bit of scented candle action. I love this. We can do that. And then also drop a painting right in the center. Over here, let's drop our bed. I'm gonna go with a simple white bed, 1 and 2, and then drop the dark oak trap doors here to make a cool little bed frame. Now on this side, let's go ahead and make some details happen here. So I'm gonna knock down this whole area and the top as well, like we did over here. Then I'm gonna put our slabs on the top again. Let's drop 2 barrels here for storage. Let's drop a double chest here in the center, right there. And then let's grab an armor stand. And then we're gonna just drop maybe like a little bit of a hat rack or something right here on the top. And we can put that with any armor as well. So I'm just gonna go with a little hat rack right there. And then last but not least, just a small carpet. I'm gonna put this over here on this side and just make a little bit of a nice little carpet action right there before you go up and down from that trapdoor. But that is it. That's all there is to it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. This was so much fun to make. It's been so long since I've done a modern house. Let me know what you think. Let me know if you guys want to see more of these. Let me know if you want to see bigger ones, smaller versions, and color palettes. Let me know. Is there any other color palette I could try? These are my go-to color palettes, and I wanted to bring what I normally do in medieval to a little bit of the survival setting. But we could definitely do some quartz ones, some big ones, some little modern style mansion. I don't know. Let me know. I'm super inspired after this build right here. But I'm out of here for now. Thank you all so much for watching. I'll catch you guys on the next Minecraft video. Goodbye.
Question your problem, please. Right after departure. Mount Crystal 36,000.